Vice President.
Well, you've been here before.
I remember.
That meeting?
With you.
I remember that meeting.
With you.
It was a special meeting, I think. Well, welcome. We're gonna have to say something later inside, right?
Yes.
Is that right?
Thank you very much all. Thank you.
We're supposed to smile. We'll smile more if we get some coffee.
Okay, thank you very much, officials. Thank you.
Say a word. Mr. Vice President, I've had the privilege over the years of standing here with hundreds of you leaders. And I welcome them, all of them, to Israel's capital, Jerusalem. This is the first time that I stand here with both leaders and say those three words, Israel's capital, Jerusalem. I want to thank President Trump and you for that historic statement, which I know you supported and championed. I look forward to discussing with you, as we've just begun, how to further strengthen our remarkable alliance. It's never been stronger. And how to advance peace and security in our region, which is our common goal. And I welcome you, dear friend, to Jerusalem. Welcome.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, thank you for the warm hospitality, Prime Minister, and it is my great honor on behalf of the President of the United States to be in Israel's capital, Jerusalem. Following on the President's historic decision, it is a great privilege for me to be here, to have the opportunity to visit with you about issues of common concern, ways that we can strengthen the relationship between the United States of America and Israel, ways that we can confront common challenges, but also I look forward to speaking with you in detail about the opportunity for peace. In making his historic announcement on December the 6th, President Trump did so convinced that by recognizing Israel's capital, Jerusalem, that we would create an opportunity to move on in good faith negotiations between Israel and the Palestinian Authority on issues that can be discussed and President Trump truly believes can be resolved. And so I'm here standing with you looking forward to speaking about our common interest in security and prosperity of Israel and the United States of America. But I also am here hopeful that we are at the dawn of a new era of renewed discussion to achieve a peaceful resolution to the decades-long conflict that has affected this region. And so I thank you for your leadership. I thank you for your hospitality. And it's my great honor to call you a friend.
Can you do it by next year, gentlemen?
Not next week.
Thank you.
By next week.
Thank you.
How quickly can you present this?
No questions.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
But we want to do it.
How important is it to you?
Very. Very.
Thank you. Thank you for us. Thank you. Thank you very much.
No, he goes on.